Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I'm your host, Jason Turner, available for code reviews and on-site training. In this episode, I want to discuss a little bit more the work that I've been doing with C++ on 6502 processors and this little project called the Commander X16. So the Commander X16 is this project to make a new retro computer, basically. It is envisioned by the 8-bit guy, who has been a prolific YouTuber for a number of years now and has developed several games for a whole lot of retro computers, including his Attack of the Petsky robots here. So David came up with this vision for a new modern retro computer that would be easy to program and easy to work with and could actually be manufactured. There's been a ton of episodes on the system. It is a 6502 based thing with a much more advanced video processor than we had back in the day and a bunch of sound capabilities as well. There's already a bunch of information available with full documentation on the official Commander 16 GitHub project, as well as an emulator available and a bunch of different games and people proving how to use it, writing software in BASIC and in assembly language. There are various prototype boards available, but nothing that has actually gone into production yet. So if we're going to do any programming on this, it has to be in the emulator sense. And I thought, you know, this would be a great opportunity to try my hand at programming this with my C++ for the 6502 project that I've been working on, just to see how easy it is to target a second platform. I'll go ahead and give you a little spoiler alert here. It is actually pretty darn easy to target the Commander X16 because it is built very much like a Commodore 64. The emulator can easily take a PRG file to launch, and its format for how to load and launch PRG files is exactly the same as the Commodore 64. So really that part didn't take too much work. What did take work and understanding is how to write data to the video. So if you take the Commodore 64, you've got your video memory. And let's just simplify this into this little window like this. So what do I have here? A 8x5 display, which is surprisingly reasonable because that is exactly 1/5 of the size of the Commodore 64's display. So if I write to byte 0, I'm going to get something right here in the top left corner. And if I write to byte 39, then I am going to get the top right corner. And then if I write to byte 40, I'm going to get the next row over. I'm going to get the first character on the second line. So the Commander X16 has, let's see, this is 1000 bytes for the Commodore 64's video memory. But the Commander X16 is actually organized much more like the VGA and EGA memory. So if you recall my last episode on dual screen support in DOS, where I covered EGA, VGA, and the MDA, then that memory goes something like the character value that you want to write to, and then the attribute, character attribute, over and over again like this. The Commander X16, because it supports this kind of memory layout and has a much higher resolution screen, like 80x50, that's at least 8K, and that's just to get started. This also supports high resolution VGA style graphics with multiple colors and way more RAM than we can actually access with a 6502. So the 6502 has a 16-bit address space and a 16-bit bus, it can only access 64K without having to do things like bank switching tricks. So what they opted for in the Commander 16's video is that you have a low address, a medium address, and a high. And you set the address that you want to write to in the video memory by writing to certain address locations for these. And then you have a third address, fourth address, that is your data port. And every time you write into this data port, it's going to actually write into the video memory that's referenced by this address. And I'll show you source code in a minute so that this makes more sense. This would imply that they've got 24 bits of address space, but that's not entirely accurate. They actually have 20 bits of address space. So they've got all of L, all of M, and the lower 4 bits of H. The top 4 bits of H is the write mode. So this has an auto increment feature. Every time I write into data 0, it writes into this address, and then it uses this top 4 bits to determine how much to increment this address by. And again, this will make more sense in just a moment. But there's also another thing to the layout of the memory for the Commander X16, in that even though you've got an 80 column display, it's actually 128 columns in video memory. So if I want to write to this location, that's 0. And if I want to write over here at the end of the display, that's 79. But if I want to write at the beginning of the next line, that's actually 129. But because of the character attribute feature, it actually is 0 to 1. And then the next line starts at 256. So this conveniently means that the low address is the column, the mid address is the row. Now let's actually look at the source code for this. I have hello X16 from C++. That's easy enough. But let's look at this code. So I've got the low address. This is the memory address to write to say which address I want to go to in video memory. The medium and the high, and then the data port. So what this looks like practically is I take the current X location that I want to write to, multiply that by 2 because I have to deal with the fact that it goes character attribute, and store that in L. And then I take the row Y and store that in M, and that works out here. And then I take H and I say I want to write at 0 for the topmost byte, and then the 2, OX2 here, the higher order bits of this highest order byte, say that I want to increment by 2 after each poke of the character. So now I look like I'm writing to the same memory location over and over again, but when I write to that memory location, the video controller is actually then doing an increment of the address L here by 2, and then the next write goes to the next location in memory. So I just take a string and I poke it into data 0 one byte at a time, starting at the location that I want it to. Like you can see, this just works out to a simple puts this value at the location X15, Y20, and then run it. And the command line is pretty straightforward. I actually just added a target for X16, even though it is currently just a copy of the Commodore 64 target. And I write this program will be written out to hello x16.prg. Go ahead and compile that real quick. And I can launch the X16 emu with my hello X16 PRG and tell it that I want to run it. And there we go. We get it printed. Hello, X16 from C++. And again, this is all part of the tool here. Now, I think it's interesting to point out that the way that this video controller works is much more closely related to the way that multi-line displays work over I2C or SPI buses in embedded computing. So playing with this, it's called the Vera video controller and the Commander X16, might be a way to wrap your mind around some of the way that other video controllers work. So, you know, this was just a fun little C++ weekly. I hope you enjoyed it, and be sure to subscribe.